In the previous video, we introduced the most advanced video segmentation model currently available. It is called SEC, and its overall performance and capability are actually much higher than our SAM 2.1. As a foundational model for the industry, the improvement in its inherent capability might not translate into immediate, visible applications for us. So today, we will use some practical examples to demonstrate the capability improvement in video segmentation technology. We will show how this improvement will lead to specific changes in our workflow. Below, I will show you four examples. The core technology for these four examples is Wan Animate. We will replace the video segmentation part within it with our CC model. Then we will observe how the overall performance changes after this replacement. I need to remind everyone that in today's video, you should not only look at the amazing performance that the SEC model brings us, but also see its drawbacks and the areas we need to pay attention to when applying it. I have also built the workflow and hosted it on Running Hub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai in the field of ComfyUI. Running Hub is a fantastic online working platform. This is because it keeps up immediately whenever new technology or extensions emerge. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in the video description section. This will grant you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you will receive 100 credits simply by logging into Running Hub every day. This allows you to try out your own workflows. The workflow you are currently seeing is a basic reconstruction of Kijai's Wan Animate workflow that I performed. Simultaneously, I replaced the video segmentation component with a CSE model. Okay, next, so let's briefly look at this workflow. First is model loading. We are using the Wan Animate 14B model, specifically an FP8 version. Furthermore, I enabled block swapping. We use two LoRAs here. One for acceleration and one for reconstructing lighting and shadows. We also have our VA model. Our text encoder is loaded within this node, so there is no need to load it separately. Next, let's look at the video processing part. This part is crucial, especially the video selection. Take a look at the video I currently selected. It features very obvious scene changes. First, we will estimate its pose and analyze its facial information. Therefore, we will use Veet Pose and our YOLO model here. After passing through the pose and face detection node, we can extract the pose and the facial information. Note this, in the facial information, the face is actually missing in several frames. However, the pose is quite accurate. This is a standard Vitae pose. Next is the part where I replace the model, the CSE model component. Here we will use the pose editor. I use the first frame, selecting the entire figure using green dots. I recommend using as dense a set of dots as possible here to ensure that all details are selected. Then, we will use the CSE model loader to load the CSE model. After that, we will use SESE video segmentation to extract the mask for the required area. I must remind you again here, the tracking option must be set to bidirectional tracking. For the generated mask, we first expand it by 10 pixels, then apply feathering, and then process it for block shaping. Finally, we draw it onto our video. Take a look, the overall result is quite accurate. Then we move to the most critical part of our entire workflow. First, we need to load a reference image. I resized it, then we use a visual model to encode it. We then use the WAN video encoder. After passing through this node, it generates the image vector needed for our sampling. After our sampling and decoding, we will get the final effect. Let's take a look. The character replacement is actually quite accurate. During scene transitions, the character's overall posture is not lost. I also think the overall detail rendition is quite good. Therefore, by using the CC model, the segmentation ability has indeed become much more powerful. This means you no longer have to worry about the final effect being impacted if your video has many scene cuts. This is a very typical application. Similarly, let's look at this next example first. Let's check the original video. The original video is actually of a virtual character sitting on a toy car. It also has various camera cuts. We use the same method, selecting the character in the first frame and then generating our mask. Let's look at the replacement effect. This result is also excellent. You should note that when I created this mask, I did not select the sword on his back. Therefore, you will notice that sometimes when rendering, this sword has some issues. There is no particularly good way to deal with this. You can only try different sampling iterations to see if you can get a better result. Next, let's look at another type of video. For this video, because I set the width and height using configuration options, the change to a horizontal screen ratio was not displayed here. The original video is actually a 16:9 widescreen horizontal video, just like the one I am currently showing you. This is a scene from a completely sci-fi movie. What is the biggest characteristic of this video? At the beginning, the character does not appear. We only see the dragon he is riding. Therefore, when using this frame, I did not use the first frame, but instead use frame 102. If this is the case, you must remember that when segmenting, you must choose bidirectional tracking. Otherwise, problems will occur. Similarly, I segmented the character here. We need to pay attention to the face. A lot of information is lost regarding the face. The reason is that the actions in the original video are very intense. Therefore, it cannot track the facial information of every frame particularly well. Now let's start generating the effect. This one is a standard 16:9 ratio. Look, the character doesn't appear at first, and then the character begins to appear. Overall, the replacement effect is also excellent. However, you must note that the quality of the face is very poor. There are even some distorted situations that appear. Therefore, we must try our best to ensure that we can track the facial information. If too much is lost, it will also affect the final quality. Finally, let's look at an example with an issue. This is also a 16:9 video, but what we see now is a vertical screen. But we can roughly see the scene depicted in this video. A person jumps down from a tall building, lands on a lower floor, rolls over, and stands up again. There are no scene cuts in this example. The character is also relatively clear. I can segment the character using a similar method. However, you must pay attention. When segmenting, we can see that in the middle part, the pixels occupied by the segmentation are getting smaller and smaller. It only gradually gets bigger again later. So, what happens in the replaced video? Let's take a look. He jumps down. Note, when the segmentation points become smaller and smaller, the character disappears. Then, at the end, he reappears. Therefore, this is also a point that everyone needs to pay attention to. Although the SEC model can accurately track the character, because the character in the middle segment of the video, specifically the part where he jumps off the building, occupies very few pixels, it is impossible to render the character very well during the replacement. We even find that the pose in the middle part is also lost. Due to all these reasons, the final video effect looks like this. This is also an issue you need to be aware of when doing video replacement. Through these four examples, everyone can see that after replacing the traditional SAM2 model with the CSEC model, the character replacement capability has indeed improved significantly. This includes the ability to handle frequent camera cuts and even situations where the character disappears in the middle and then reappears. However, we also found some issues. If the facial information is not captured sufficiently, the face may become distorted. Additionally, if the pixels rendered by the main subject are insufficient, we also find that the subject will disappear. Therefore, there are both positive examples and negative examples. When applying this, everyone should pay attention to these situations. Okay, that is all we're covering today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.